standalone productions. Yo, check it.
Yo, check it.
Where do I go from here? Somebody please tell me.
I work as a researcher for a large research and development nonprofit here in Columbus, mostly for government contracts dealing with the environment and public health. I really started doing self-portraiture just to have images to put on Facebook for profile photos, and then I just ran with it. I mean, people had a good reaction to them, and I started getting a little more experimental with them. And the iPhone was just a way for me to always be able to produce something, always be able to experiment, no matter where I was, no matter what I was doing. Whereas, you know, with the DSLR, you're lugging around a big kit. So with my iPhone, I just point and click. Sometimes I will set things up. I do have a little tripod system. And that's where some of my more conceptual work comes from. There's definitely a thought process there. I would describe myself as an image manipulator. I don't consider myself a photographer because most of what I do is after I take a shot. The post-production for mobile photography is pretty complex with my work. Almost all of my images are 2, 3, 4, 5 images combined into one. I do a lot of superimposing. You know, for the most part, I try to do as much as I can in the field, so to speak. So sometimes I'll put like, I'll shoot through bottom of a glass, or I'll put pantyhose on top of the lens or something like that to give it more realistic atmosphere versus just applying a filter, though I do use a lot of apps. My work has evolved quite a bit this past year. I was exploring new ways to display my artwork, and one of the things I've been doing lately is transferring images onto wood. And then that developed into taking scrap wood and creating these mechanical interactive pieces where I'm inviting the viewer to touch them, to play with them, to maybe pull on something to reveal a hidden image. If you really look at my work, if you know my work, it's actually a pretty straightforward evolution. My images themselves invite the viewer to interact with them just because they're kind of, they're narrative and they're storytelling, and everybody who looks at my work gets something completely different out of them. For example, I have an image I recently did where it was shot from the floor and you just see feet dangling over the floor. And I've heard everything from she's hanging to she's jumping for joy to she's floating to she's, you know, disappearing, and people have always interacted with my work in that way. So to move on to actually physically interacting with my work seemed like a logical progression for me. I have very vivid dreams, and I keep a notebook beside my bed, and every night before I go to bed, I get on Pinterest for about 10 or 15 minutes, and the inspiration just comes from everywhere. It could be a picture of a forest. It could be, a donut. It could be anything. When I look at Pinterest and get that inspiration right before bedtime, then I tend to dream a little bit more. And then when I wake up in the morning, I sometimes have a concrete idea of what I want to do. I am not making art every day. I wish I was making art every day, but the inspiration comes and goes. I'm shooting photographs every day. Now, whether I do anything with them or not is a whole other story. People are always surprised when they learn that I'm in the sciences and not in in the arts. I have so many ideas. I don't even know what's next. It's just whatever hits me at the moment. Somebody please tell me what now. It's fine that I'm out.